This is Tom Radke. I'm seeing all these videos about how to clean out bone from your arteries, how to reverse arterial sclerosis. Is this possible? And is there one secret food that you can eat that magically reverses this? Well, I was kind of blown away by some of the results, and it's really opened my eyes. I'm going to tell you about it, all the research and the benefits, and we're starting now. So why is a podiatrist talking to you about arterial health? Well, I have PTSD from amputating essentially hundreds of toes. There were weeks where I would amputate 10 toes, 10 feet in 1 week. It is such a common problem. Arterial disease, diabetes, these are all getting worse. The statistics are going out of control. Our calories are going up. Our arterial disease is going up. Our diabetes rates are going up. I spend all day dealing with vascular disease, working with vascular doctors, doing these procedures, wound care, toe amputation. So this is very important for me. So I try and stay on top of all this because this is something I work with every day. I'm going to tell you about the number one food for a vitamin called vitamin K2. I did not know much about vitamin K2. In fact, the government does not really have any strong recommendations. But initially, I went to a lecture with a well-known cardiologist. And he was bragging about how people who eat this essentially limit their cardiovascular disease. They clean out the calcium from their arteries. I link a couple of those sources below, but I'm going to tell you what my research shows and what that food is. That vitamin is K2. I always knew about vitamin K1. It's important in blood clotting, but vitamin K2 has historically been in our diets. It's very high in meats. It's very high in certain vegetables, but now no longer. We're eating more calories than ever, but we're getting more nutrition than ever. I was reading a study that since 100 years ago, there is about 90% less magnesium in our food. That's very true for vitamin K2 as well. Our nutrition is decreasing as we're eating more pastries, more grains, more baked goods. We're eating less meats, less green vegetables. Let me tell you about the top 10 benefits of vitamin K2, and I'm going to count them down from least important to most important. Number 10, improvement in exercise performance. Studies do show that vitamin K2 could impact exercise performance because it does work on mitochondria. That's the powerhouse energy sector of our cells. Number 9, skin health. Early research in vitamin K2 shows that it can play a role in skin health, potentially reducing aging. Who doesn't want that? Number 8, anti-inflammatory properties. There are a lot of great natural supplements for inflammation. Vitamin K2 is another one that shows anti-inflammatory benefits, although more studies are being done. Number 7, brain health. Emerging evidence suggests that vitamin K2 has neuroprotective properties, especially in the prevention of Alzheimer's disease. So there is a few studies that are looking at Alzheimer's disease and vitamin K2, but early on, it looks like it does provide some benefit. Number 6, diabetes management. The European Journal of Pharmacology has shown that vitamin K2 may improve insulin sensitivity, thus helping with diabetes. That's no secret because it's part of a healthy, balanced diet that we're going to talk about. Number 5, dental health. The role of vitamin K2 in dental health, particularly the remineralization of teeth, has been observed. There was a famous researcher, Dr. Weston Price, and he essentially studied this over decades and said if patients are taking the proper amount of vitamin K2, he's never had any that haven't had a cavity. I know that could help me. I'm starting to eat it. I have 4 kids. I don't want to be paying for braces for 4 of them. I don't want to be fixing cavities for 4 kids. Number 4, reduced risk of cancer. The American Journal of Clinical Nutrition found that there was an inverse relationship between vitamin K2 intake and the risks of certain cancers, especially prostate cancer. This is not universally accepted, but more studies are ongoing. Number 3, supports blood clotting. Vitamin K2's role in blood clotting is well established. Now we hear about blood clots more than ever. Over the last 3 years, potentially. I don't know why. I don't want to get demonetized, so that's as far as I'm going to go. But there's a lot more blood clotting happening. I think statistically that's shown. Eating proper diet, proper nutrition, that could potentially impact that. Number two, cardiovascular health. A significant amount of research, including studies published in the Journal of Nutrition, support the role of vitamin K2 in reducing arterial calcification and lowering the risk of coronary artery disease. And number one, bone health. The most substantial and well-supported benefit of vitamin K2. Numerous studies, including the Journal of Bone and Mineral Research, have demonstrated clearly that vitamin K2 supplementation improves bone mineral density, decreases fracture risk, especially in postmenopausal women. So I go over a lot of arteriosclerosis videos, a lot of osteoporosis videos. I go over all that stuff in detail. A lot of stuff is important for bone health. Specifically, we're talking about how to get calcium out of your blood and into your bone. The way I like to think about it, and these are well-proven studies at this point, is vitamin D puts calcium into your blood. Vitamin K2 takes that calcium and puts it into your bone. If you don't have proper vitamin K2, that calcium can get into the wrong places. Calcification can occur in your arteries. Very, very common. When I was doing my cardiology rotation, I remember I was working with a thoracic surgeon, and he had the heart open, and I could actually see the bone in the arteries. It felt crunchy. It was not flexible. It was crazy. It disgusting, basically. Like when you look into your own body and you can see bone inside your artery, it's not a beautiful sight. Vitamin K2 is not the most well-known vitamin. There is a lot of ongoing research. Vitamin K2 in arterial health upregulates something called the matrix GLA protein, which inhibits calcification in the artery. A study in the Journal of Nutritional Biochemistry suggested that vitamin K2 could prevent or reduce vascular calcification. So the way I like to think about it is if you're in terrible health, it's not going to turn you back into a 15, 20-year-old where you had perfect arteries. That's not possible with all of us. We're on this earth for a reason. We're going from start to finish. We could slow it down a little bit, but we can't reverse it and get young again. There's no way to make 80-year-old skin look like a baby's skin. There's no way to get nerves from peripheral neuropathy to be a baby's nerves again. And it's the same thing with your arteries. You can prevent it from getting worse, but if you have bone crust buildup, you can certainly improve your health dramatically. No one's saying you're going to have perfect arteries again. So when all these claims are made that you can remove calcium from your arteries, you're really preventing it. You're living a healthier life, and it's better to start now. The best time to start was yesterday, but the second best time to start is today. That's a great way to think about vitamin K2 and arterial calcification. A study in the Journal of Thrombosis and Hemostasis indicated that vitamin K2 intake was associated with reduced vascular calcification and lower cardiovascular mortality. This is a very promising, but it does not conclusively show that there's a reversal of calcification. So it is really good to take it, but might not reverse that. Vitamin K2 works by activating proteins that regulate calcium deposition in the body. By activating these proteins, specifically one called MGP, it helps to prevent calcium from depositing in the arterial walls, a process that can lead to hardening and narrowing of the arteries. But it is important to know that more research is always needed. There's never a perfect answer. Compared to vitamin K2, other factors to consider, very important to look at your diet overall, especially diabetes and sugar intake. That creates a ton of inflammation in your arteries. A crazy statistic is that 50% of people right now over 40 years old have some type of arterial sclerosis. It's terrible. You want to cut down smoking, you want to cut down alcohol, any type of inflammation. And I'll go over my big secrets at the end. But the number one food for vitamin K2 is a Japanese dish. I actually enjoy this. I love beans, but it's called natto. It is renowned for its high vitamin K2 content. It's not necessarily something expensive. The process of fermenting soybeans, essentially a bacteria ferments soybeans, and this results in the production of high vitamin K2, specifically in the form of MK7. So both MK7 and MK4 are important. MK7 lasts long, MK4 lasts a little bit less, but potentially has more benefits. Natto contains potentially the highest amount of vitamin K2. There are other foods that contain it. Check out my guide below, but a lot of meats contain it. Natto is by far number one, though, because that bacteria creates it. There's a lot of different ways to prepare natto, and one big trick is I heard that freezing destroys that vitamin K2, but looking at it further, the more I did research, it seems to be flimsy evidence. Tell me what you think. So you can freeze it, you can store it, you can potentially make that natto and have it last a long time. If you're on blood thinners, so warfarin, for example, or other medications for blood clotting, taking a lot of vitamin K2, so eating a ton of natto, just be aware, check with your cardiologist. It could change your bleeding time. It can change your clotting time if you're eating extreme amounts. But for the average person that doesn't have atrial fibrillation or isn't on blood thinning medications, you should be okay because it's a natural food. Natto is rich in vitamin K2. It has a lot of fiber, has a lot of B vitamins and minerals. This is a superfood. It is highly proven in studies for cardiovascular health, cardiovascular benefit. Potentially, it could reverse calcification. It's not really proven. The studies are pretty clear that it does help with bone health. It does help your arteries long-term, at the very least preventing further damage. The downside is it's an acquired taste. It could be smelly. It could be sticky. It could be slimy. I personally love eating beans. They're delicious for me. At the same time, if you have soy allergies, you might not be able to consume natto. And as I mentioned, blood thinner or warfarin interaction, you have to be careful. Check with your doctor. That's the secret food to clean out your arteries.
This is a chart of the top 20 vitamin K2 foods, and ideally diet is the way to get it. So there's a Japanese fermented dish called natto. That's number one. And I have a whole video going about natto and the supplement natto kinase. That's the natto kinase supplement right there. But cheeses as well, goose liver, chicken liver are also high options. You can see the first couple options have the most vitamin K2, but also eggs, Gouda cheeses, goose leg, pepperoni have some, salami has some. So you can see the deli meats, a lot of meats have vitamin K2. So vitamin K2 is a fatty supplement. It's a fatty vitamin that you can get in through your diet. It's also in butter. I have videos about butter as well. So MK4 and MK7. The MK4 lasts shorter, but potentially has better absorption. Or MK7 lasts a little bit longer, but potentially has worse absorption. So getting it through your diet, this is foods that will give you a nice mix of it. So I'm not picking one vitamin K or the other. This is a good option to get it through diet. So as a supplement, you want your 90 to 360 milligrams per day. And a lot of supplements now, in a practical sense, you could get it both with all the mixtures of MK4 and MK7 with your vitamin D as well. So you could get one of the combo ones, and I link those below. But taking a look at all the studies, the average doses were 90 to 360 micrograms. And most of the studies now are very encouraging, especially for bone health and for limiting arterial calcification. It might not reverse it all the way, but it can help you stay healthier and just work it in as part of your supplement routine. That's the best way to go about it, in my opinion.
Check out my osteoporosis videos, my vitamin D videos, reverse that arterial sclerosis, and I go over my best home remedies as well.